Polynomials. You have seen polynomials last year. You know the definition and also some basic terms in the polynomial. We need those basic terms here also. So we may have a quick review of those basic terms and also some results in this polynomial. A polynomial is a mathematical expression whose coefficients are real numbers and exponents of the variables whole numbers. There are polynomials in one variable, two variables, three variables, and so on. But our discussion is restricted to polynomials with only one variable. Usually this variable is taken as x. And hence, a polynomial in the variable x is usually denoted by px, polynomial in x, px. It may be denoted by this fx, gx, qx, and so on, and so on. And now, there comes the term degree of a polynomial, degree. Degree of a polynomial is the highest exponent of the variable in the polynomial. Highest exponent of the variable in the polynomial. If the highest exponent is 1, the polynomial is said to be of degree 1, or the degree of the polynomial is 1. For example, consider px is equal to, say, 2x plus 3. The variable is x. The highest exponent of this x is 1. 2x raised to 1 plus 3. So this is a polynomial of degree 1. It is also known as a linear polynomial. Linear means degree 1. If the highest exponent is 2, the degree of the polynomial is said to be 2. It is also known as a quadratic polynomial. For example, if fx equal to x squared minus 5x plus 7, the highest exponent of this x variable x is 2. So the degree of the polynomial is 2. That is, this is a quadratic polynomial. If the highest exponent is 3, the degree of the polynomial is 3, or it is also known as a cubic polynomial. Example, 2x cubed plus x squared plus 8. Highest degree, highest power exponent is 3. So, cubic polynomial, polynomial of degree 3, cubic polynomial. If the highest exponent is 4, the polynomial is of degree 4, or it is again known as biquadratic polynomial. If the highest exponent is 5, the degree of the polynomial is 5, and so on. So on. And now there comes value of a polynomial. Value of a polynomial for a particular value of the variable is that value when the particular value of the variable is substituted in the polynomial expression. That value obtained when the particular value of the variable is substituted in the polynomial expression. For example, consider this px is equal to 2x plus 3. When x is equal to 2, the value of the polynomial denoted by p2, which is equal to, substitute x equal to 2 in the polynomial expression 2x plus 3. So which is 2 into 2 plus 3 which is equal to 4 plus 3 which is equal to 7. If x equal to 3, we get the value of the polynomial at x equal to 3 which is p3. Similarly we can find. That is, for any value of x, we can find the corresponding value of the polynomial. And now there comes the term zero of a polynomial. Zero of a polynomial. Zero of a polynomial is that value of the variable x which makes the value of the polynomial zero. That value of the variable which makes the value of the polynomial zero. For example, consider this fx is equal to, a polynomial fx is equal to, say, x squared minus 5x plus 6. X squared minus 5x plus 6. And now, for x is equal to 2, this f2, the value of the polynomial f2 is 2 squared minus 5 into 2 plus 6 which is equal to 4 minus 10 plus 6 which is equal to 4 plus 6 is 10, 10 minus 10 is 0. So this is equal to 0. The value of the polynomial becomes a 0. Therefore, x equal to 2 is a 0 of the polynomial fx. Similarly, suppose x equal to 3, then f3 is equal to 3 squared minus 5 into 3 plus 6 which is equal to 9 minus 15 plus 6 which is again 0. 9 plus 6 is 15, minus 15 is 0. So we see that 3 is a 0 of the polynomial, another 0 of the polynomial. So we obtained 2 zeros. Generally, there is a result. For a linear first degree polynomial, there is 1 0. Second degree polynomial, there are 2 zeros. Third degree polynomial has 3 zeros, and so on. A polynomial of degree n will have n zeros, a general result. And thus we can find the zeros of a polynomial. And now, the geometrical meaning of the zero of a polynomial. Geometrical meaning. For this, consider fx, a polynomial. Suppose we take this y equal to fx. Y equal to fx. So we get an equation, a functional equation, and we can draw the graph of this equation in a graph paper. Graph of this y equal to fx. Suppose we draw the graph. Suppose y equal to fx, fx is any polynomial. Suppose the graph is like this. Suppose the graph is like this. We know the zeros of the polynomial are those values of x which makes fx 0, that is y 0. Y 0. In the coordinate plane where this y value 0, on the x-axis, y values are 0, y coordinates are 0. Particularly, at this point y 0, this point y 0, this point y 0, this point also y 0. All other points, y 0. But these points will have certain speciality. These points are the points where the curve meets the x-axis. Curve meets the x-axis. At these points, all these meeting points, we have x and y, x coordinate and y coordinate. Y coordinate 0, and x coordinate will have different values. At this point, we have x coordinate, x value, that is the distance from origin to this, which is x. Corresponding to that x, y is 0, which means x is a 0, that point is a 0 of the polynomial. Corresponding to the value of x here, at this point y equal to 0, so it is also a 0 of the polynomial. Corresponding to the value at this point, fx 0, so that it is also gives us a 0 of the polynomial. Similarly at all other points. That means the zeros are those points on the x-axis which are the meeting points of the curve and the x-axis. The x values on the x-axis, x coordinates on the x-axis, where the curve meets the x-axis and itself. This is the geometrical mean. Okay? And now, finally, there comes a relation connecting the zeros and the coefficients of the polynomial. There is a close relationship between the zeros and the coefficients of the polynomial. Suppose we have a first degree polynomial. The most general form of first degree polynomial is ax plus b. There is a term involving x and there can be a constant also. So the general form is ax plus b. The zero of this polynomial is that value of x which makes this expression zero. So that can be obtained by equating this equal this to zero and solving for x. That will give us the value of x which makes this zero. So if this ax plus b equal to 0, ax equal to minus b and x is equal to minus b by a. That is, the zero of that polynomial is minus b by a. That is a relation, zero and the coefficients, minus b by a. If it is a second degree equation, the general form can be taken as ax squared plus bx plus c equal to ax squared plus bx plus c. The zeros of this are obtained by equating this to 0. Now, solving for x, we arrive at certain results. Relationship connecting this zeros and coefficients. Suppose alpha and beta are two zeros of the second degree equation. Since this being a second degree equation, it will have two zeros. Two zeros for the polynomial. And solving or simplifying, we see that this alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a and alpha beta is equal to c by a. That is, sum of the zeros equal to minus b by a and product of the zeros equal to c by a. We can see that. And for a cubic polynomial, similarly we can have certain relationship. The general form can be taken as ax cube plus bx squared plus cx plus d. Suppose the three zeros are alpha, beta and gamma. Then solving for this zeros, we can arrive at the result alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b by a. Sum of the zeros is minus b by a. And sum of the products of the zeros taken two at a time, that is alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha is equal to C by A. C divided by A. And product of the zeros alpha beta gamma is equal to minus D by A. So these are the three relations connecting zeros and coefficients of the polynomial. So remember all this. These are important. Frequently we use these results in problems. Okay.